Okay, good afternoon, everyone.
Evening, sir.
Thanks, sir.
Okay, we continue to chapter 11 or week 12 ya. Chapter 11 in Turban book. We will discuss knowledge acquisition and also validation. So I have shared the material and some simple code in Python for the quiz ya, assignment, group assignment. Okay, first we this chapter 11. First we will discuss about this story opening vignette. Yeah. This is about the use of expert system, knowledge base. There is the pharmaceutical company in US. They produce some fermentation and they have difficult for quality parameters. Even though they use the statistic, but they still have a problem. Jadi bisa yang sampel, sometimes there is a chance of employer, so they have difficult to make the precise. Yeah. And also for 24 hours control, yeah, without computer based system. So they use the gen sims G2 for controlling and for quality. Yeah. So they have success, yeah, in real time advice, yeah, to operators. So they don't need full expert operators. Just a called a knowledge acquisition or getting the expert knowledge, yeah, into the system, yeah, or artificial knowledge, artificial expert. So first we have to acquire or gather, yeah, or knowledge, engineering process activity, acquisition, validation, etc. You can also see from this step. Yeah. Thing. Sorry, I have share again. Okay. And then we go to the knowledge engineering process. This is the main part, yeah, knowledge base. So after we get the knowledge, we have to validate them. Also there is some feedback from expert. This is the source of knowledge and then getting the knowledge acquisition, and we should create the knowledge representation. I will give demonstration to use to show the knowledge representation using the Python. And then also there is another source explanation or justification. This is the additional from the system. And then this is the testing or validation to ensure that the conclusion from the system is equal. Yeah? All the experts agree, yeah, for the conclusion. This is already in this book, yeah? Same. You also can read this some success story as well. This is in Egypt. Diagnosing expert system. So in assignment, you should search the problem, yeah? Problem, you, and then you create the rule base, yeah, similar to if then, yeah? If then, and then insert to the code, yeah? Just copy paste. Yeah? Scope of knowledge, of course we have to give them the limit, the limitation or scope from the expert in order to efficient. Not all knowledge, but some important knowledge for inference engine. So last week we have discussed the term knowledge. Knowledge, information, and data, you have to distinct between them. Knowledge is collection of facts, procedural and adjustment rules. This is the definition from expert system. The source of knowledge may be from document or undocumented people's mind, databases, and internet. Usually this is using the big data. And also there is level of knowledge, shallow, dangkal, deep, dalam, special, abstract, analogy, and etc. You have to consider this level. And then there is a major category of knowledge. There is a declarative, procedural, and meta knowledge. Declarative is factual statement, deklarasi, deklaratif. And this is shallow. And then this is the initial stage of knowledge acquisition. And then we go to procedural. Procedural, which thing? Step by step. Yeah. This is more deeper, yeah, than declarative. Procedural also include explanation, automatic response, how to, and also how to make inferences. This is procedural, very algorithmic, and this is using the sum step. And this is the new knowledge, so called the meta knowledge. Or we call knowledge about the knowledge. So meta knowledge in expert system refers to the knowledge about the operation of the system, the knowledge based system. So because we create a system that have knowledge, yeah? So we have to not only understand but also make the system understand, yeah? So knowledge about the knowledge This is the term in psychology or education, meta-knowledge. For example, you study the decision support system, and if you use the meta-knowledge, you maybe know what you have understand and what you do not understand. So using the meta-knowledge, you can learn fast, because you only learn what you don't understand, and if you already understand, you might maybe pass. This is the meta-knowledge implementation in education psychology. This is the engineering skill, post computer, tolerance, effect communication. You have to not too specialist, but you have understand the another domain, because you create the system that maybe relate to some specific discipline, for example accounting, health, transportation, and etc. So you have to broad advanced verbal skill, because you have to acquisition from expert, from doctor, from lawyer, etc. Fast learning, especially for some specific domain. For example, you have to create the expert system for map or geographic information system. So you have to first learn the GIS, GIS concept. And organization experience in knowledge engineering, white intelligence, and etc. This is for engineering, knowledge engineering. This is the knowledge engineer first retrieve the knowledge from the expert, or using documented knowledge and create code. So we will try this using the coding. I have shared you in eCampus the sample, forward chain. This is the rule. This is on the explanation. The rule is generated in this. This is the rule, and then this is the only, sorry, this is actually the question or the case. Actually, this is the rule, and then create using the if statement, or I will share. You can directly open now. I will share in chatting for okay. I will chat. Okay, I have shared in chat. You can open and then try to use your own laptop or computer, and then this is gather from the user, expert, and etc., or maybe for the requirement of the some expert. This is only simple how to create the simple rule. For example, this is the domain of the biology, for example. If A is a mammalia, mammal, and then A is the vertebrata, tulang belakang. And there is another knowledge. If A vertebrata, then A is animal, binatang. And also if A is vertebrata and can fly, flying, so the A is bird, burung. So, we will check the case duck that vertebrata. This is a duck vertebrata, and also I will delete this. And duck flying. So, and then this is the function. This function is called, the name is asset fact. And this is the global variable, means that this variable can be accessed from another every function. Yeah. This is already, we have to one only one function. Usually some variable only for specific function, but using the global, this means that this can be accessed outside the particular function. Set function, and then this is the problem, sorry, that for testing vertebrata. This is actually a duck vertebrata, and duck can fly, and flying. So the system will searching, is it mammal? No. So they go to this. Is this vertebrata? And then this is vertebrata. So the system will insert the new animal, ya, because vertebrata, there is a rule, vertebrata will be animal. And also, there is two facts, vertebrata and flying. Vertebrata and flying, so there is another rule, if then, yeah, vertebrata and flying, and then they give the result is the duck is a bird, yeah. So we just click this run cell, and then they will give the first conclusion is animal. Yes, yeah, animal. Vertebrata is animal, so duck is animal. Then also ducks, because is also bird. So this is the conclusion of the system from the knowledge base, and then we go to the conclusion or inference. Another sample, for example, mammalia and cat. So this will searching in rule mammal. You see that mammal is the vertebrata. So we search it, mammal is vertebrata, but there is a set fact, yeah, new data. Yeah. That not only mammal but also vertebrata, because if mammal also vertebrata, and if vertebrata, so the A is animal, so the cat, we run again, the cat is mammal, ya, sorry, cat is animal, ya. You see that there is a chain rule, yeah? Mammal and vertebrata animal. So if a cat is a mammal, so also a cat is animal, binatang, yeah? Even though there is no mammal go to animal, there is no rule mam that directly rule mammal into animal, but using this rule chain, we can see that mammal is also animal using this rule. Mammal, vertebrata, vertebrata, animal. So you have a task I have plot in the campus. The it is simple task. Maybe you can discuss in your group to create some sample, ya. Maybe a credit approval, best employer, and etc. Outside the this problem, yeah. This is for scholarship. For example, I have asked to the maybe a decision maker want to create the scholarship for a student A. If the A is middle income and clever, so we will get the half scholarship. So for rich student, we do not give the scholarship. For poor and clever, we give the full or Fulbright, yeah, full scholarship. For middle income and low GPA, we do not give the scholarship. And also this is from the expert, or maybe from the document, yeah. Document we will use data, yeah. I will explain later to the data. So we have create this 1 2 3 4 5 rule. It's 1 2 3 4 5 rule. Using this if statement, if middle income and clever, we will give the half scholarship. For rich student, there is no scholarship, and etc. And this is for student named Andy. This is rich and medium GPA. So we will see rich. Of course, there is no scholarship for Andy. Even though we do not see there is a medium GPA here. Oh, there is here. But for this, no scholarship. So you will create the answer for Andy is no scholarship. For example, if Andy is poor, yeah, for example, and then poor and medium GPA, if we see the rule, poor and medium with half scholarship. Okay, we run this half scholarship for Andy. Another maybe poor and, for example, clever. So they and they get the full scholarship. So you see, this is not using the number, but using the symbol. So the expert system maybe not use the number, but using the symbol. And sometimes we use this using fuzzy. If the data is a number, and then we convert the number into this symbol, yeah, or linguistic symbol using the fuzzy fuzzification. We will discuss later fuzzy. So you have task to create some problem here. Maybe you can see from the slide. I think there is some Sample ya, for example, where is it? Ya, oh, there is a applicant. There's a income, asset, age, dependents. So this is the decision. For example, there is an income 50,000, an asset 100,000, age 30, and 3 dependents. And decision will give the application or maybe the credit or something. Yes. Another case, for example, Mr. Smith, income 40,000, there is no asset, age 33, and 2 dependents will reject it or no. You can use this sample, but you have to convert this into the language or the symbol. Yeah? Maybe this is high income, maybe below 30 low income, and then no asset, medium asset, and high asset. This is old, young, or medium, yeah? Medium, or young, or you can just young or old is okay. Dependents, maybe small, medium, or large. And the decision, and then this you have to just from document, and then you have to convert into this system, yeah, into this. You have to get the task, and then you have to test whether the result is according to the rule from the expert or from the document. This is the explanation for the knowledge acquisition coding, and this is the induction. The induction is from a lot of samples, and then you have to give induction and then code in knowledge base. This is how to gather the knowledge using the interview, face to face, and interview unstructured, semi-structured, and structured. Maybe using the Google Drive, Google Form, sorry. It's the unstructured interview. You can use a lot of variation here. Yeah. Talk through, teach through, and read through. Maybe some simulation. Yeah. Where is the simulation? Yeah. You can build representation and knowledge. If you have shown the movie, yeah, the founder about the MACD, you can see there is some knowledge from the source of burger, yeah, creating burger using the simulation in some court on lapangan, ya, yeah. And then they create some simulation to process the, and then it will be implemented to the system. How long is for every part of the steak, and then they create the burger in 30 seconds. So the knowledge can be gathered using some source, yeah. Maybe some using simulation, and maybe from explanation or teach through teaching from the expert, and etc. The structure interview. So the interpersonal communication is important, yeah, to get the good acquisition. Yeah. This is the recommendation. Next, this is the process of recommendation how to create the or gather the knowledge, yeah, from the expert for the knowledge engineer. just a protocol analysis and tracking method. You can read from this ebook. Yeah? Inference rule also forward chaining and backward chaining. This is a sample how to use the backward chaining. Backward chaining is different from forward because forward chaining is from this and then we go to conclusion. For backward chaining, we start from the conclusion, or for example, you can see the read the goal, or the then part, and then you move backward, to. And there is a decision, this is or. So in backward chaining, there is every branch should be analyzed here. If no, you go to here, and then there is some conclusion, A and B. For example, there is some sick person or cancer and etc. And then we analyze using this, and then the conclusion is the cancer is from the source of the cancer, for example, for ill people. Forward chaining. See some sample the grid. This is the some methods for export driven. There is another optional using the computer aided semi-automatic to gather the knowledge from the expert. The grid. Just the usually language, Lisp, Prolog, C++, COBOL. Maybe today we add another new language, Python, MATLAB, or Java, etc. This is the orientation. Maybe there is some symbolic calculation or numeric calculation. These are some sample of expert system, Aquinas, Kriton, EasyGrid, WebGrid, and then support. Then this is the famous rule using the induction. This is the reasoning from some specific to general. There is a lot of fact data. And then we get the conclusion. And also there is some interactive induction using some like this using the graphic representation. For example, this is the tree. You see there is a similar problem before. Then these two brands, and then this is the final conclusion. This is the inference tree. Another method, maybe this is the for scholarship. Nearest neighbor. This is for scholarship. I use the some data here, data for training, and then for one sample, we will calculate the distance from the neighbor. You see, this is the distance. And if we use the k is 3, so we have to find the class of this three neighbor. If the three neighbor is scholarship, so the result is scholarship using the vote. Yeah, there is a voting here. Or we can use this Scikit-learn. This is the famous library in Java. Scikit-learn, this is the center k nearest neighbor. You can just import ya. Neighbor classifier, yeah. This is easy because we only code some little line code, yeah. Because we just call the function neighbor classifier, yeah. This neighbor classifier, where is the function? This is how to use this library. This neighbor classifier. This is the how to use. Also, you can go to the source code, yeah. If you want to understand more in detail, you can see this is the source code. There is a class, and every class there is a function and attribute. Yeah, this is the attribute, and this is the function. Init is in Java similar to the constructor. Yeah. Constructor, there is another function or method, yeah. Fit. Yeah. This is usually one try to training, yeah. Train, yeah. And then also predict for testing, etc. And if you want to ask question, you can see this is the contributor. Sampai udah Juan Carlo. Sisa developer ya, from UC Berkeley. Yes, you can also use the classification report to check the accuracy, 91%, and then also you can predict, where is the sample, predict. Of course, you have to upload this file, yeah, this to the upload, yeah, or here upload, and then you have to same name with this and etc. But I will prepare, yeah, the I will share you this the data in the campus next. And this is the validation. you if you create the inference system or machine learning and some expert system, you have to not only data for training but also data for testing and validation. Maybe if the expert system you're using without the there is no document or data, the validation maybe from the human expert to check the accuracy of the system. Transcription plus indexing, knowledge gathering, this is the method acquisition. Knowledge diagramming to graphic representation. And so there is some concept, conceptual graph. And there is a 50 slide that you can read by yourself. There also there is some sample here. Yeah, you can also use this for your task. This is the decision. What is the probability? And number of near phrase, near robot transposition. Maybe this is for sample using induction table, ya. So this is the you have to create this rule for if you want to use this as your assignment problem. Okay, I think I will stop the class here and capture the attendance. Okay, thank you very much for your attention and good night. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, sir.